subjectivity. But intrinsic value has got least of this subjectivity. It is most objective. Why it is most objective? Because what I am doing is, I am estimating the future cash flows. And I am discounting those future cash flows by my cost of capital. Isn't it? So when my future cash flows go, future cash flows को discount करता हूँ, so when I discount the future cash flows and I discount the future cash flows with the cost of capital, we will understand as to how do you derive the cost of capital, because that's a very very important number in the entire exercise of valuation. And so discount करने के बाद total of all the present values for all the years is the intrinsic value. It is subjective only to the extent, and please pay attention, it is subjective only to the extent that the cost of capital can vary from person to person. Yes or no?
Yes.
Are you with me? Yes. Because please remember, the cost of capital is not same. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि सबकी कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल 15% है. नो, कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल विल वेरी फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. एंड व्हाई इट विल वेरी फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन? व्हाट इज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल? ऑल ऑफ यू, व्हाट इज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल?
एक्सपेक्टेशंस, रिटर्न एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम माय इन्वेस्टर.
फैंटास्टिक. व्हाट इज वेरी गुड. दैट्स वेरी गुड. बट डज इट इज इट ऑल, और इज समथिंग एल्स टू इट? So cost of capital will have two components. You know, we know WACC, weighted average cost of capital. Are you all with me? Isn't it? So उसमें क्या है? उसमें debt है, उसमें equity है. Debt की cost find out करना problem नहीं है. Is it a problem? Debt की cost find out करना बहुत simple है, because rate of interest minus equity minus
tax.
So that becomes the cost of debt. Very simple. You also have to add to this cost of debt is the cost of equity. And how do you find out the cost of equity? See, the plain simple rule of cost of equity is the expectation of the investor. ठीक है, अब मैं किसी business में पैसा लगा रहा हूँ. What is that I want to earn minimum from that business? That is my cost of equity. But in the exam that you will write, you will not be allowed to use that figure, because if you are allowed to use that figure, then you know it will vary from the person to person, and the it is all objective type question, so answer is same, so everybody will have a different answer. What in the exam you will come across something which is known as CAPM. You know what is CAPM?
Capital
Asset Pricing Model. And this is the most frequently used tool for arriving at the cost of equity. Any idea how do you get the CAPM? CAPM कैसे मालूम पड़ेगा?
E is equal to,
yeah, okay, very good. K E is equal to
RM plus beta into RM minus RM.
Fantastic. Now, so cost of equity is equal to
RF
plus
beta
into
RM
minus
RM.
और मैं आपको एक चीज और बताऊं कि आपके एग्जाम में जो केसेस आते हैं वो रिपीट होते हैं, सेम केसेस कीप ऑन कमिंग टाइम एंड अगेन, एंड इनवेरिएबली यू विल नॉट हैव टू कैलकुलेट द कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल बाय यूजिंग सीएपीएम, बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन. So the cost of capital is given, and interestingly, they will give you the cost of capital. Still, they will give you, this is the risk-free rate of return, this is the beta, and this is the market thing. So if there's a possibility, you might get confused, and you know you may start calculating the cost of capital, and suddenly you realize that it is already given there. I'm just telling you because you know when you come across, so much of time is you are able to save. Do you understand this formula? How many of you understand? Are you clear about दिस नंबर ओके 1 2 3 4 5 क्या बीच की लाइन का ऐसा ही है क्या बीच की लाइन वाली क्लियर है बाकी हु एल्स मैम आई क्लियर अबाउट दिस फार्मूला व्हाट अबाउट यू सर ओके सो व्हाई डोंट यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन टू एवरीबॉडी या यू आई आई रिफर बोथ ऑफ यू सो जस्ट एक्सप्लेन दिस फार्मूला टू